Let's see how to perform a quadruple test with SsdwLab5. First, we introduce the username and password, and appear by default the profile of first trimester combined screening. We will have to exchange this profile for a quadruple test profile, in this submenu, where predetermine quadruple test profile, and then we exit to the data entry main screen. Here we introduce the name and the surname of the patient, which are two essential conditions. Also, we have to introduce the screening date, that it's the date of blood sample extraction. Another imperative condition is date of birth, which will give us the age of the patient at the screening time. It is advisable to introduce a code identifying the patient, such as the number of medical history. Then we introduce the patient race, that is a correction factor. In this case, the race of the patient is black. In the next folder, we will introduce the gestational age of the patient, and will appear the weeks and days of gestation. The number of fetuses will be a single fetus. Also, we introduce the weight of the patient, that is a correction factor, on the next screen, or in the following folder. We can introduce, although not mandatory, the identification number of the analysis, and we can define the report language, which in this case would be English. In the following folder, we introduce the alpha theta protein value, and we can observe that automatically presents the multiple of the median. Then we enter chorionic gonadotropin value, in this case would be the total chorionic gonadotropin. The next biochemical marker is unconjugated estriol value, and the fourth parameter is the inhibin A. When we have calculated the MOMS of all markers, it will be presented the patient's age risk, trisomy 21 risk, and trisomy 18/13 risk. If we want to see the report, we save the register, click cancel printing, and then we click to enlarge and see better the report. What we see is what will be reproduced in the printed report. We can observe all the data about Down syndrome, Edwards and Partow, and graphics related to each risk. Suppose we wanted to do a triple test, then we just cancel the inhibin A and we obtain the result of a triple test. And if we want to realize a double test, we cancel the value of unconjugated estriol, and it only will take in count the alpha theta protein and chorionic gonadotropin values, whereby the risk is for a double test. And so this simple way we performed a quadruple test.